As we go to air tonight, bushfires are bearing down on Kingfisher Bay Resort on Fraser Island. The hotel is closed, with guests ordered to get out while they still can.
Sand and surf meet barren bushland, the devastating result of several dry seasons and a hot start to summer. The World Heritage listed National Park burning on two fronts, homes and a luxury resort tonight on the line.
It's a beautiful place, it's very sad to burn that.
Hervey Bay's ferry terminal turned into an emergency hub. A convoy of fire trucks lining up to go to the island as guests from Kingfisher Bay Resort were forced to leave.
It was sort of red sunlight yesterday, you know, and all the smoke. Still the sort of we shouldn't be here.
I think it's a good decision if it is safe.
Cathedral's camping ground on the ocean side is also under threat.
We've got crews working on both fires at the moment and just making sure that those communities that are closest are protected.
What's thought to have been sparked by an illegal campfire more than 6 weeks ago has now burned 40% of the island, destroying 76,000 hectares of a fragile and unique ecosystem. Water bombing and fire breaks are helping, but there's one problem. With predominantly sandy soils, the island is like a sponge. Firefighters say it doesn't matter how much water is dropped on the ground, moisture is almost impossible to retain.
Water bombing alone just won't extinguish this fire. We would love some rain, but that's not forecast, so we believe that we could be in for still a few weeks left with this fire.
Fraser is now a fortress. Unless you're a resident, you can't go over. Daily ferries have stopped, but barge services are making extra trips so tourists can get out.
The flames really took hold and, the eastern side is just, doesn't look good.
Right now, residents here on Fraser Island are getting ready to defend their homes and businesses. We're just off the shore here at Kingfisher Bay Resort, and while conditions have eased, you can see this big smoke cloud is moving in behind me. Usually, the pier and beach here would be packed with tourists and holiday makers, but practically, it's a ghost town now. Speaking with several accommodation providers over on the island, well, they're on their knees. They've battled the pandemic. Now this bushfire is threatening to take away crucial tourism dollars at the peak Christmas season. Money, Andrew, they can't afford to lose.
Yeah, it's an eerie backdrop as well, Annie. Thank you. A record-breaking heatwave has settled in across Queensland. Natasha Kramer joins us from Enoggera Dam. Natasha, the conditions have got authorities on edge.
Yeah, they certainly do, Andrew, and the temperatures have been climbing all across the state today, and November records have been smashed. Now, as you can see behind me, there are still quite a number of people trying to cool off, and it was similar scenes all across the coast today. There was people trying to cool off in the water and also seeking shelter indoors in the air conditioning. But we need to spare a thought for those towns out west, places like Birdsville sweated through 47 degrees, and in the Darling Downs it was sitting around the 40s in towns there. So it's that heat that is really causing concerns for authorities. It's moving east, and we are expected to see it within these next couple of days, and major concerns for the elderly and children as it's the high temperatures mix with the long stretch of heat.
People become complacent. So when people become complacent, they're outside, they don't drink enough fluid, and they start to get the symptoms of heat exhaustion or heat stroke, and that's when it can become very serious.
While heatwave conditions will appear to initially ease, we're not expecting any long-term relief in that regard.
So weather experts are warning us that the worst is yet to come. Wednesday was predicted to be the hottest day, but temperatures are expected to climb all the way through to the weekend now, Melissa.
Natasha, thank you for that. Well, this heat wave is really just a full stop on what has been an incredibly dry month. Weatherman Gary Youngbury joins us now. Gary, the Gold Coast has broken a weather record.
That's right, Melissa. On the Gold Coast this evening, they have smashed the record for the driest November. It was previously set back in 2014 with just over 25 millimetres. The average for November is about 120 millimetres. This month, only 19 millimetres in the GC's rain gauge. We won't see any rain overnight. Keeping in mind, 15 millimetres of that fell on the ferry first day of the month. So a new record in November for the Gold Coast. Brisbane and Ipswich went close to it, not quite breaking any records there. But over the next few days, it's not about rainfall, it's about temperatures. And I'll have all those lofty coming up in our 7-day outlook.
We'll catch you then, Gary.